Welcome to the channel, everybody. My name is Ryan, and this is RimWorld, and we are back at the Hussar and Highmates colony. Here are a couple of our pure-blooded Hussars here, and yes, that's right, Cinderman has yellow eyes, not red eyes. No, it's not because he's the genetic freak, it's because he's got some architect upgrades. And here's Morgan. Let's see, Morgan, who are you the child of? Cinderman and Shay. So Morgan's standing right next to her dad right here. They're working together, getting me some plasteel out of the ground. I wish it was regular steel, and at some point I might have to have them go for this little patch, but we're working on trying to find some more. And so you get to basically the real bottleneck in the colony is steel, pretty much. Components are up there too, but I'm working on getting some more of those. And the good news is, oh, we've got a caravan just about to return home. Now, of course, it is possible that they could still get attacked, but I have confidence that they can take care of themselves. Shay is a non-violent pawn, but she's our royal pawn too, so she's got some tricks up her sleeve. But if they make it home, well, they've got a lot of good stuff with them, some steel. And just, I think we've got some other components too to trade, but it was a fairly successful trade. I don't want them to spend too long outside the colony. That was the goal, is just to have a quick one where we basically go for a few key strategic resources that we need. Man, oh man, look at Buddy. The whole time I've been talking, he's just turning out the masterwork stuff. There it is, number 5. He's making hats, I think is what he's working on, right? Yeah, cowboy hats. There it is, buddy. Good job. And that is Thrumbo fur that you see there. Oh, yes. Our colony is loaded with the Thrumbos. We've got domesticated Thrumbos. We've got Thrumbos in the freezer. Well, they've been butchered now, but you can see we're putting their textile, their fur, to good use. And all those cowboy hats get to be placed right over here inside our guest's bedroom with the lounge area, where we will now sell these hats alongside some beer we've got for sale. There is usually some food in this one, but we're all out. And we've got Psychite tea on sale too. This is unfortunately just a small shadow of the hospitality that I want to eventually get laid out here in the colony. We're getting there though. We are, I think, making more and more progress. This is the big project though. This is where all our hospitality facilities are going to be, out here over the water. And I admit, I was a little too ambitious with this one, but I didn't realize just how much resources, because these bridges here take steel and stone to build. And you can go over deep water as well as the shallower river water with them, though. So it's very helpful. You can see some deep water right here. But I've got a little bit of granite, and I've got definitely enough steel. Let's go ahead and lay some out here. We'll do this together. You'll see just how resource intensive this is. So I'll start with the deep water bridge, because I know there's some area over here that needs it. There we go. All right, right there. That's right there is about what I can lay out currently with the resources I've got. Just two little, not even full length trials across there. But you know what? Actually, let's see. I'm going to cancel that, and I'll tell you why. I just now remember this, but I had mentioned one thing I want to do is I'm going to focus, instead of getting the whole thing built right away and then doing it, I think we'll fill out this little section here. And I mean, obviously, I've already got this one built too. So we'll do something with these first. We'll kind of do it in stages, in other words. So with that being said, let's start this area. Okay, now I just need the regular bridge in this particular location. There we go. See, that makes a lot more. Obviously, it's a skinnier area, but another thing to keep in mind too is I'm going to be building walls around this entire area too. So these, you know, this is all going to be walled in here. It's, you know, once we get the bridge itself complete, so yeah, there's a lot to go here. Now, I have been on a whole chunk collecting spree. As you can see, I've got a couple of stashes down here for our stone cutters. Most of it's come from the map itself. Like, I've literally scoured most of this map for stone chunks, and even the steel is starting to come in handy now too. What I'm doing is, instead of using the like high priority haul urgently, which would get the colonists out here, this way, if I just turn it on a regular haul, the Thrumbos will come out and pick it up. I've got a few of them set. Did one of them die? Maybe. Yeah, I thought I had another adult Thrumbo female. I got to be careful with some of these girls here. We've got three left, apparently, and they are pretty badly injured. Let's just take a random look. Oh, yeah, brain scar. Two brain scars. Left eye is pretty bad, and she's probably one of our healthiest. So, yeah, we need to be careful here, because if we look at our animals tab, most of these juveniles are males. Well, they're all males. So these are the only breeding females we have. Which just means if we get another raid, I can't rely on them as much, but that's okay. That's okay. Once the caravan gets back, oh, look, they are back. Okay, they're back. Let's see. Wait a second. Animals tab. I guess we did lose a Thrumbo. How? Maybe I'm crazy, but nonetheless, I felt like there was a fourth female. Anyway, I won't worry about it too much right now. Is this the one from our caravan? Oh yeah, sometimes it's good to check these. I'm gonna force them to just drop it here. I don't know what it's doing, but get all this stuff off of it, because you can see we've got some important stuff here. What is this? Skill trainer, intellectual. We got a low shield pack. Yeah, this is coming from the caravan itself. So we got to get that back. And of course, we've got Shay is back. And I think it was Wrench or Arslan. No, not Wrench. Arslan was the pawn that went with her, I believe. So there we go. Wrench is in a special situation. Where is he? Oh, he's down here in the growth pod. Look at this big boy. Taking up that whole chamber there. Baby Wrench is his name. Is his first name still Baby for real? Oh my God. How? Why? Anyway, who cares? His name's Wrench. But he is in a growth chamber until he turns 18 for us, because he had his final actual growth event where we got to distribute his, you know, skills and traits. So now, since I want him to become combat ready as soon as possible, and I don't really care about him building his skills up that much, I mean, we got plenty of skilled colonists. This guy is just getting some accelerated growth here for us. So, like I said, he's going to be our very first, like, melee-dedicated pawn, too. And I'm really excited about that. He's got himself a nice little weapon. Okay, you know, I was just going over this animal tab again and again. I was actually butchering some of these animals, too, getting rid of them because we're getting low on kibble. But I realized we do have the fourth Thrumbo, and it is here. It is now at the top of the list because I named it. This was the one that I did take on the caravan with me, right there, Spiny. I just named it, and I wanted to be able to see it in the list and pick it out when I was going on the caravan. So we do have four. It's just now, unfortunately, when it gets named, you know, it's alphabetical here, I guess, I assume. Not really, because this S is before the C. I don't know. They're just grouped together by letter. But nonetheless, interestingly enough, the stallion is down at the bottom. I have no idea how these are grouped now, come to think of it. So it's whatever. But let's see. Yeah, the squirrel just got thrown at us. Thanks a lot, Randy, for nothing. We scanned some steel. Where is it? Let's see. Oh, it's so far outside the compound, I couldn't even spit on it if I cared about it, right? We've been having really bad luck with our scans. Like, I think there was one batch of steel right here inside our little area, our little fortress. But everything else has been outside the walls. Super, super annoying when that happens. But we're dealing with it. And I have these wonderful looking bathrooms to help compensate, to help me get through the nights, you know, one of those cold, cold nights when I'm thinking about all the gold we don't have. But, oh, look at this. Strong's taking advantage of the sauna here. Hello, Strong. She takes her clothes off, of course. Who would go into the sauna with full clothing? This is amazing. And it's kind of a hallway, too. So it's a multi-purpose room, but it is amazing. Now, I will say that these sauna structures are kind of expensive. I mean, for us, when we were scraping by on stone and steel, it's tough. Same with these. It's 170 steel and four components for a hot tub. But you can see I've got this area decked out for real, real comfort. So we're going to get there. It's all coming along quite nicely, actually. I really like the bathrooms. I need more. I don't think six is truly enough to facilitate everybody, but it's more than what we did have. So it's definitely an upgrade. Now, I've got a few people over here being forced, yeah. Okay, Furry, let's let you finish. Cinderman, ooh, yes. This will be the last round. I picked out a few pawns who could do the stone cutting, and I forced them to. Because like I said, I'm real conscious about trying to get some of this construction done, but they need to take a break. They're getting pushed to their limit. Oh, wow. Look at this one. It's got a name that, for a quest, I really, really appreciate the name of this quest. Bloodshed for Profit. Straight to the point. No, like, frills, no euphemisms or anything. Just straight there. Bloodshed for Profit, baby. I'm all about that. But the one thing I don't like about this quest, look what it says. The junkers will arrive in transport pods, probably right on top of me, and either inside my stockpile room or I would guess inside my hospital. Those are always the two rooms that seem to get the most attention from drop pod raids. But my God, I want to do the quest because it's got some decent architect arm, baby. You can see we don't really need the pulsers. I've got like three of these already. 900 uranium would be good for, yeah, we're getting a little low on fuel. Not really, but it would be good for some more nuclear power plants. I've already got an architect leg. I just realized that. I think that came from our trade caravan too. So, well, you know what? I can't, like I said, I don't want to risk the thrombos. Maybe I should, because in a drop pod raid situation, yeah, it's going to be the thrombos who are probably doing most of the fighting. Or at least they're going to distract the raid while we shoot at them. In fact, that's why most of these people, or these people, these thrombos have injuries like this, is from being shot, unfortunately. Not from the raiders either. Okay, well, we come full circle right back to Morgan again out here pumping away at the deep drill, and I decided she will get the architect leg basically because she's the only pawn who's just got one bionic leg. Everybody else has a pair of them essentially. Well, I've chose the other pawn who doesn't actually. Sorry. Strong has one architect leg and a bionic toe, so I would hate to get rid of that toe. So yeah, but most of the other folks have a pair there, if I've given them anything at all, you know? So, like I said, Morgan's a good candidate, I think. I guess I could give it to Strong. That would be double architect legs on Strong. Yeah, now that I'm noticing that, the middle toe is kind of just a meme. I think we got this bionic toe from something. I don't remember how, but I certainly didn't craft it up to replace her toe, although she was missing a toe, so it was a nice little bonus at the time, but this way, she'll get the matching architect leg. Sorry, Morgan. Let's get over to Strong, actually. Okay, Strong, we're focused on you. I made a mistake. Let's bump up her medicine. Of course, if she's getting something like an architect leg, then I'm definitely going to give her the best quality medicine we have. And let's do it's a left leg. So install architect left leg. And now she's going to do something, but I'm going to have her reset that so she'll go and rest in the hospital. Very good, Strong. You're an obedient little pawn, and I love it. You deserve these legs here. We still don't have medical beds, but yeah, it's too much resources for me. So let's see here. Oh, look at this. Shay is super ready for this. My only concern with Shay is her bond distance is actually affecting her consciousness. Shay, I love you, but step aside. Let's get somebody else up here who's like got a actual bonus to their manipulation and stuff to do it. Get over here, Shepard. I need you to prioritize operating. Again, if it was just a bionic toe, then Shay would do, I'm sure she'd do nicely, but can somebody get the thrombo out of the hospital, please, for the love of God? Okay, well, there we go. That is a beautiful representation of a toe, by the way. I love that, with the cuticle and everything. Wow, very detailed. But Strong is looking good. She's under anesthesia, but she'll be fine. Oh, matching architect legs. That's a glorious thing right there. Can't wait to see what her total movement speed's going to be. Especially, she's got the bionic spine too. Let's go. Oh boy, well, I was just laying out some of the walls, adding some more bridge over here, as promised. I'm really starting to push it, but the good news is we got a little growth event here, so let's pop this out. It's for our boy Killer, the pure-blooded Hussar. Actually, it might be a female, I'm not sure, it's not important. No, gender does not matter here on the rim. Everybody is equal in the eyes of Randy, so let's see here. Baby. Oh, here we go. Two skills and a trait. Well, ooh, we haven't seen much aesthetic. We've got a few good traits here. Iron willed. That kind doesn't really suit the Hussar. I mean, I think we actually might have a couple of hybrids with that trait already, but I want iron willed, I think. Yeah, for us, that's good. Now let's see. Shooting, don't need it. Construction. It's always good to have a good construction person down the road, especially. Let's do these two. Yeah, artistic again, not really one that fits the Hussar that much. So good solid construction and crafting sounds good to me. All right, killer's well on his way. Where is that little guy? Little guy or girl? Male, okay, yeah. So he is just one of our artificial test tube babies, so to speak. We got a couple of those that I was trying to play God with, but now we've just been having some fun populating the colony, almost pure generational. There's a couple of exceptions. Actually, both of them are sleeping next to each other. So Furry was brought on board to help us with the thrumbos, and he's sterilized. His genes will never be passed on, so we don't have to worry about it. And then there's little Elsie, who is a waster. She's not sterilized, but she was adopted when she was born in our prison. Her mother was a raider who attacked us. Not Duck. Duck is not her mother, not with that glorious beard. No. We released the mother, but we had the choice to either execute the baby, the newborn, or adopt it. So you know me, I'm a sucker for wasters. I said, come on aboard. But, you know, so Elsie is still a child. So 8 years old, it's not going to be an issue. Even if once she does get to be fully grown, I plan on just making her a little cottage out here in the pollution zone. And Elsie can live like a secluded hermit on our map here. No, I'm just kidding. We won't do that to her. But it's not a bad idea. There is this little spot right here. And honestly, once I extend us across the river with our bridge and stuff, this might be a very real possibility for Elsie to have a little cottage over here. Because in case you are unfamiliar with Waster, that particular xenotype does get a bonus if they live or have, you know, exposure to pollution. It's, I can't remember exactly what it's called, but it'll appear here in the health tab and it gives them a little boost to their consciousness and whatnot. Okay, well, once again, we've got our crew over here being forced to cut blocks, and this time I've got them all high on go juice. And actually, Cinderman is currently high on Luciferium always. But yeah, they are pumping out the blocks now. You know what? There's a mod out there that allows you to build an electric stone cutting table. I think I'm going to reinstall that in my next playthrough, if I go for an advanced, like, high-tech playthrough, that is. But it is a helpful one for sure. This way, you know, I mean, three just basic tables is pretty good. I'm almost tempted to lay down a fourth one, too, with the quantity of stone we are eventually going to need. It's tempting. I might as well. Let's just do this. I mean, imagine having a fourth pawn in here, hopped up on go juice, helping out. It would be good. And let's see. Yeah, we're getting a nice little stockpile. I'm also in need of statues too, so keep that in mind. Let's see here. Sass is currently our artist. She is pregnant, and I have a feeling I've got her prioritized. Yeah, well, actually, her art is the priority, but, well, no. Okay, cooking is her priority. I think I will set her down. Let's go check on our freezer real quick, just see how the food's coming along. Looks like we've got a decent little stockpile here, stir fry. Well, not that much. Actually, that won't last very long, but so much of it just depends on the fact that we run out of produce. We have tons of meat, as you can see, but almost very, very little, like, actual fruit and veggie that we can harvest. So what I'm doing is I am currently taking some of that precious steel. In fact, most of it just got drained away here on some more advanced hydroponics basins, but these are worth it for sure. In fact, you know what? I just researched fruit, so let's turn some of these into the various different fruits we've got available. We'll do blueberries, grapes in one, and you know what? There's something else I wanted to do here too. Oh, I need some cotton, but I'll just wait. Food is more important, so let's do some strawberries. Watermelons will be good. Yeah, you can see everything's kind of just hodgepodge spread out. I've just been placing different types of harvestable crops here as needed while I go along. So, these constructors are handy, but they are pretty slow. I'm still glad we've got them. Of course, Clarissa is our current mechanator, but I'm keeping it pretty light. We're not doing too much with that, just some help here around the colony. And I'll tell you what, it has made a huge difference, no doubt about it. All right, should we go with more rice? Now I said we'll do a full slew of the fruits available, but I think the last two I will just leave as rice because that's one of our best producing crops, no doubt about it. All right, well, we just had an exotic goods trader stop by. Hold on, I'm getting interrupted by research real quick. Let's see, what should we be going for? Let's start doing some more of this stuff here. What am I looking for? I'd like to get organs. Oh, we do have organs. Okay. So I just need the bench then for it. Tell you what, let's focus some more on these war caskets. That might help us defend the colony a little bit. But the reason I wanted to show you guys here was that we just had an exotic goods trader stop by. I didn't get much because we're pretty low on silver. Actually, now we're just about out of silver. But we got an insanity lance and a shock lance, which is very helpful. But let's grab pain right here real quick. I did check out the contracts and take a look at this. 4 EMP grenades for 9,900 silver, almost 10K silver for 4 grenades. So it's a pretty decent markup, 166%. Definitely not the best like markup, but the best thing that we can produce, you know? Like there's no way I can do like 450 Glitter World Neutronamine, or 800 Flake right now, even though that's a great markup. So I've got our boy right here, Buddy, working on him. Oh man, these actually take a lot of work. Yeah, he's not even halfway through it. It's still got 200 work left, but I gotta give him a bit of a break. Luckily, I think there was like 30 days left on that contract, so we'll be able to make some decent silver off that for sure. And if you guys are new, just tuning in for the first time, you're wondering what this trade terminal is. It comes from the Vanilla Trading Expanded mod. Very cool. Oh, you know what? Don't we have stock too? Let's take a quick look at our stock. So we'll grab pain again. We'll go to open stock market. And if we do, we might want to sell it. Oh, hold on. If I go to profit loss or recent change. Oh, no, I have to click it there. There it is. Oh, wow. So it's definitely up, but it's starting to go down. You see that? All right, we're selling it. Wait, to positive, to numbers, to negative numbers to sell. All right, I've got 30, so probably just better if I type it in. There we go. And confirm. So we're going to get money in transferred to our bank is going to be 6,100 silver, and we'll put it in the Imperial Bank. I'm pretty sure that's where I get the best like interest rate and price wise and stuff. So we'll go for that. Confirm. Oh, we just did. Okay, and did I? Confirm. Confirm. There we go. Okay, so now if we were to call the bank. Imperial Bank, and we want to withdraw it. I just do this. We can see the fee. Here's the bank fee, 5.1%. So we get a little bit less than 6,000. Confirm it. Yes. Close. And there it is. Delivered fresh, shiny silver right there, ready to spend it. All right, Strong is going into labor, and this is like her ninth child or something. She was literally able to walk to bed, so she's used to this by now. But Shepherd is, of course, the husband and the doctor, so it's just the two of them. Gonna take a little while to get that set up, but in the meantime, we can admire our brand new hot tubs. So these are interesting. First time I've ever used them. They come from the Dubs Bad Hygiene, and it does kind of sink in with the hospitality, I assume. Yeah, because we can change the price of these. I turned them down to zero just so our colonists will use them too. Looks like we can link a bed as well to these, which is interesting. So I don't know, connect to fixtures to nearby beds so they inherit ownership. I'm not sure how, like, what that's really for. We can also do unisex. I guess we can, restrict it to men and male and female only, but that's cool. I like it. A lot of granularity, a lot of control there. And yep, starting to shape up over here. It's hard to see it because the plans, I've got some plans still laid out, which I can remove these. It's just I was going to remove them all at once. I don't want to forget what the shape is, but you can see it's coming along nicely. And I've even started to put a little table out here for our construction crew so they have a place to eat and stuff. But this I like it. I like the looks of the colony right now, guys. It's getting pretty exciting. Finally starting to see it fill out and come together is nice. Now, once we get real big groups of visitors and we've got like a store going with, I think we've also got a casino mod. So, oh, that's going to be exciting to see pawns like lose all their money to us. I'm looking forward to that. But we are going to wait here and hang out just to the very end to see what the baby is. I know we can inspect the genes, but we'll treat it like it's a real surprise and we'll wait till it pops out onto the floor. Okay, and we're just moments away from the baby. There it is, healthy child. Look, he actually picked the baby up immediately and gave it to the mother. That's incredible. I've never seen that. Usually the father just like abandons him. He's ready to go eat and have a beer or whatever. But of course, the baby gets immediately put. Oh, I think. Oh, Strong's actually feeding it. Oh, holy Christ. Strong is amazing. She really lives up to her name. She's over here starving and she's breastfeeding the child. Now it's on the floor. Okay. Now that's good. Just where I want it. Now I can actually insert it. No, somebody's coming to pick it up, I think. Because I can't put it in here. I don't see it as an option. Where's the baby? To me, that means somebody's probably coming to get it. So what I'm going to do, you can see reserved by Lady V. All right, Lady V. Oh, there she is, being a dutiful mom. So now the baby should appear in the list, right? Oh, no. Oh my God, did somebody else come to pick it up now? All right, hold on. Now I'm not sure. Maybe I need to unpause it and repause it. Well, nonetheless, I'll get the baby put into the growth pod. We've got three babies in there. One's a big baby, but of course we know it works. I'm not sure what's going on with it right now, but yeah, not a big deal. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for joining me for today's episode. It has been a fun one, very peaceful, but we're making some serious progress up here, so I'm happy about that. Hit that like button for me, guys. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so, and I will see you all on the next one.